What's happening, everybody? This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back again with the final map of TNT Evilution, Map 30, Last Call. Now, straight away here, we have quite a nasty little trick behind this door. And it's got to do with these torches. You see how all these torches are just lined up in rows here? Well, this is not for just for decoration. The order of these torches is extremely pertinent as to how you do this next area of the map. So let's open the door, get rid of all the enemies, which includes the demons, the cacodemons, and the lost souls, which are all the way out there. So let's go ahead and get rid of them with rockets. And yeah, we can just chain gun the stragglers now. Alright, you die, Kakko. Come on. There we go. Come on. Pesky lost souls. Alright. And you. Alright, so, take a look at the map with me. What we've got here, you see how almost all of these platforms are highlighted with orange? Well, the ones that are highlighted represent teleporters. If you step on one of the highlighted tiles, you will teleport into a room with something called a voodoo doll. Basically, it's a nasty little trap where you telefrag yourself. So what you want to do is, obviously, you want to step on the ones that aren't highlighted in orange, which are all these right here, in order to get to the other side. So if you don't want to constantly look at the map all the time, or if you can't remember the order of the torches, I'm going to show you right here, and I'll also show you the voodoo doll trick in the extras video for Final Doom. So, what you want to do here is take the one on the right first. You want to go forward, forward, left, forward, left, left, backward, left, left, forward, forward, right, right, forward, forward. It's actually not that difficult to memorize once you get the hang of it, but it is just, it's got to be one of the, it's such a dick move. I mean, because it's like, it's the final map of the game, and they're all, like, they're still trying to kill you unfairly. It's just not right. Okay, so he's dead. We will save that supercharge and mega armor, and we are full on energy cells. So what you want to do here is run around here, press this switch. Now, I'm going to go ahead and run over here and press this switch. Like, well, yeah, this switch over here. Do that. Whoa! Jumped over those Revenant missiles. Now, you want to take out the Arachnotrons as quickly as possible, and then what you want to do is start wailing away on the Revenants. And if you've got seeking missiles following you, you can hide behind one of the pillars to not take any damage. Or, if you don't want to do that, you can also, you'll also want to move around in a circle so that, you know, they'll just circle around you. That actually did not go by so bad, and we still don't really even need this stuff, but we'll take it anyway. Alright, so let's progress. Actually, wait a minute. Everybody dead? Whoop, get out of there. Everybody dead? Yeah, everybody's dead. Alright, let's go down here. Okay. You die. Switch. Now. Hey! Look who's here! Yup. The last cyber demon of TNT Evilution. But not Final Doom. Oh no. Now you want to keep a close watch on him, because if you're standing out in the open like this, he can fire his rockets at you. But if you're standing behind this pillar here, it doesn't matter as much. So let's go ahead and get rid of this cyber demon. Come on, just die. Okay. So just come on around here, pick up these rockets, and then press that switch. Now, when you do that, you want to hurry back over here, because these steps are going to start raising up. And you really don't want to have to climb all the way around this thing, because it's just, it's so annoyingly narrow. But, interestingly enough, I've had cases where this doesn't raise to the top, and I've had to jump up here. But anyway, go ahead and grab the red key, and, wait, will this reopen? No, crap. I was going to go back for that energy cell pack, but oh well. There's still more energy cells in this map anyway, but, yeah. Let's just go up here. And we still don't even need this stuff, but we'll pick it up anyway. Alright, so, yeah. And we'll just make our way on down the marble hallway here. Now, interestingly enough, you'll have some enemies that will raise up in these cages here. You don't even have to kill these enemies straight away, and I will show you why. As crazy as it sounds, you don't have to kill them. So let's take this teleporter here, and here is the final area. We have to destroy the demon spitter, so let's run up and do this as quick as possible. Press that switch. Now see, all these guys that are teleporting in here are the enemies that were in the cages. And they don't all teleport out at once, but they will telefrag each other sometimes, which is extra nice, but, yes. Like I said, they don't all teleport out at once, and if that's the case, I may have to go hunting them down again. So, but yeah, we've woken up the Demon Spitter, and he is just releasing all his monsters, so what we need to do is make quick work of this. So, let's get rid of you. Oh, Chain Gunner. Never good. Okay, let's teleport back, because we need to check and make sure that there's no other guys. Nobody's there. And is anybody there? Nope. Alright, yeah, I didn't want to fall out the window there. Well, it looks like everyone has teleported. And if you see any hitscan enemies, they teleported in here. The Baphomet did not, or the Demon Spitter did not spawn them. Yes, kill him! Whoa, 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 don't kill me. We don't need to die, not here at the end. Okay. Crap. Alright, you die. You die! Oh, no, 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 no. Alright, now, what you want to do is stand right here on, like, the second... Or, like, the second or third step. It's not working. Crap. See, what they did here... And this is another really big jerk move. But, like, what they did... It's like you need to stand... There we go. And that's it for the Demon Spitter. Alrighty. Whew. That was Last Call. And, yeah, but basically what I was just saying about the Demon Spitter is that if you try to fire at it from, like, the top step or, like, where you picked up the rockets where the enemies teleport or where they spawn... it's not gonna do any damage. Like, when they mapped the Demon Spitter, they mapped it so where, like, they put the Romero head boss brain slightly underneath, like, the brain on the icon's face. I don't know what happened. I don't know if it was intentional, like, if they wanted to be deceptive, but whatever it is, they screwed it up, and it's a failure. But the other thing is, this map really just is not... I'm not too fond of this map as the final map. I mean, you can actually do stuff, like it's an actual map, whereas, you know, Doom 2's Map 30, Icon of Sin, was just, you know, one big huge room where you just battled the icon, but, you know, it's like, it's the beginning. It's like, they really just, I mean, if you don't have... If there's no way that you can view the teleporters with the platforms, it's just, like, you'll just walk onto one and, like, teleport and telefrag yourself. It's, like, it's not fair. But, yeah, other than that, I just really, like, the caged enemy part where you can just let them all teleport in, that's more or less, I mean, if you just leave them alive, I guess that does take some of the weight off your shoulders, because, you know, you don't have to shoot them from where you are, because it's a pain in the neck to kill them in the cages. But anyway, that's Last Call, and it's kind of fitting that we finished TNT Evilution on a down note, so let's move on, shall we? Let's see what happens. Suddenly, all is silent. From one horizon to the other, the agonizing echo of hell fades away. The nightmare sky turns to blue. The heaps of monster corpses start to evaporate, along with the evil stench that filled the air. Jeez, maybe you've done it, Have you really won? Something rumbles in the distance. A blue light begins to glow inside the ruined skull of the demon spitter. And with that, we have finally come to the end of TNT freaking Evilution. And you know, I'm so thankful to be done with it. See, the problem here is that it's not entirely Team TNT's fault. I mean, they really did make a horrible, crappy megawad. But a lot of the blame goes to id Software. What were they trying to accomplish when they bought this? It's like, what did they, like, did they think this WAD was more special than all the other ones? I mean, like, when they purchased this WAD from Team TNT to include in Final Doom, it's like, I mean, like, people in the community were going, okay, what in the world, like, what makes these guys so special? And there were a lot of divided opinions because of this. Because this WAD was just so bad, and it's still one of the most infamous mega WADs out there. Like, if you go to doomworld.com and you go to, like, the top 10 most infamous WADs, this one's, like, number 4 or 5. I can't remember the exact number, but still. I just don't know. And, I mean, granted, not all of TNT Evilution is bad. Like, the first half, like, maps 1 to 15 and the two secret maps are fine. Well, except map 8. The first half is fine. Then you get to this other half, which is, like, completely dependent on the same theme over and over again. And all you get is just the same repetitive garbage. It's like, there's no denying that just these later maps, it's like, by the time I got into, like, map 20, I really wasn't feeling it anymore. I just wanted to, like, stop playing this. Because, like I said in, like, in a past map, I can't remember which one, it really, by the time you get to, like, map 22, which is horrible, this game really isn't even worth playing anymore. And it's a shame that I have to say that about a megawad that could have had so much potential. But whatever happened during the making of this, it just really just fell flat. And we just ended up with a horrible megawad in an official release. But, yeah, and guess what? It ain't over either. We've still got to do the Plutonia experiment. Yeah, so yeah, Final Doom ain't over yet. So, I guess when we come back, I will see you all then. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.